Let me start by saying I've seen obviously the first two episodes. They're so good. I think fans are going to love it. Bunch of questions. Haley, I'm going to start with an individual for you. When you joined the MCU, who gave you the best welcome message and who shared the best advice about the MCU?
Oh boy. I had a really great meeting with some of the producers and with Jeremy. And it was kind of it, I wasn't quite sure what the situation was. I didn't know if I like had the job yet, but it kind of felt like maybe I did. It was a little up in the air, but I just remember feeling so much love and so much support from the people in this room, Jeremy especially. And as soon as I know that I did in fact get the job, he made himself very available and very clear to me that he was there to support me and be an ally through all of this. So that was awesome.
Jeremy, I have an individual question for you, and this is a very sincere question. My friend Rob, favorite character is Hawkeye, loves you in this role. So this, I'm going to say it direct from him.
Okay.
Rob wants to know what it's like being the best Avenger and always winning despite having no powers, armor, or guns.
I think it's the greatest opportunity ever. It's I love this character, and I love being able to express it in the 6-hour show. He'll love it even more. He's gonna love it a lot more because as well, you'll see.
No, completely. And that's actually something that I really love about the MCU shows and Disney Plus is you get to explore so much of characters that you could never do in the movies. You know,
Yeah.
like moments with your family at a restaurant, you
Yep.
could be spending that much time that never exists in a movie. So can
Right.
you sort of both talk about how you can, you know, what the MCU on Disney Plus can do?
Yeah, I mean, look, you have, when you have 6 hours, you can do a lot more. You can spend a lot more time with character and character development. This is why I think people really love the long form of storytelling. They get much more invested in the characters. A lot of times in big movies, it's more story driven, right? And not so much character driven. A lot of times. But when people start following character and the character's behavior and can really, I mean, you could end up, putting Kate and Clint in any scenario. That's what I kept telling people at Marvel. It's like, look, guys, just not trying to overwrite this thing or anything. To put them in any scenario, that's what people want to watch. And that, because that's the characters that they adore. And they, so we get also spend time with them. Like you said, just going to the grocery store. Maybe it's just doing something mundane, but a deepening of respect and adoration and this humor and a lot of other things kind of can come up because we get to stretch out the time spent with these characters.
Yeah, Haley, actually, could you talk a little bit about that? My one of the things I listen, every one of these shows is going to have great action. We all know that, but it's what Jeremy just said. It's those little character moments where you guys are like bickering or talking. That's what the fans are most going to respond to. Can you sort of talk about filming some of those scenes?
Yeah, I mean it's part of what I think I was so drawn to with this that groundedness that you know the reality of a lot of what they're going through is humorous. It's also tragic, which is where a lot of the humor comes from. But I love that. Anytime I get to, you know, sink my teeth into a moment like that, it's a dream. And then on top of it, we do get the crazy epic adventure and action that sort of ties it all in and balances it all out.
One of the, I guess one of the, something that I really enjoyed also that this series does is it shows how Clint is human. You know, like the hearing aid moment for me is like just reminding you of the physical cost of doing this. Can you sort of talk about that, another example of something you've not seen in the movies?
There's, I think, well, I think that's, there's a lot of that, for Clint, his backstory is the cost and the price you pay physically, emotionally, spiritually, wanting to do the job and having like an eager, overeager partner, wanting to do it, but a little caveat, or there's a few of those things. And I think Clint is dealing with that. And he's, the hearing aid, loss, the hearing loss, was part of the comics and something that we're trying to find a way to get it in to stay truthful to the comics. And I'm glad we were able to do it in the series.
Haley, are you, this is a jokey question, but are you looking forward to filming anything called Young Avengers?
A jokey question, huh?
Exactly.
I will tell you that I am so excited about the idea of people watching this show, meeting Kate Bishop, a character that I very quickly understood why she is so loved, and I'm excited for them to meet this version of her and see what happens in the show.
Grandpa Hawkeye, really old Avengers.
This is my last question.
Come on now.
This is my last question for you guys. I think that a lot of people who really love the series, I would so engage in this, but I want to ask this last question. I think a lot of people don't realize what goes on behind the scenes and in making these huge action set pieces. So for both of you, can you sort of, because it's all glamorous when they're watching it, but they don't really know the minutia of it. Can you each sort of talk about what it's really like behind the scenes filming one of these action set pieces for Marvel?
You're enjoying things that may look cool, may look amazing. You have, your body has to be prepared for certain things, and it's never as easy as it looks. Having a fight sequence on an ice rink, perhaps, maybe, or look. Like, even having a bow is the most ridiculous weapon to have to fight with when you're doing hand-to-hand combat. It just walking down the hallway, you're getting stuck.
Oh, man.
I mean, it's just the most impractical thing. But in the costumes, and it threw my shoulder out for a good 3 months, right? I know she's having trouble with one of the cool patches that she had, but it kept banging her. But there's a lot of things that aren't practical. But, I mean, it's all part of the game. It's all part of like what the process is. And it certainly isn't, it isn't easy, but it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. It's wild to see. I still am so blown away. I get to do this for a living, and I've been doing it for a while now. And I still get so excited when I see that this is how this stuff gets made. And so much of it happens in front of our eyes. And then there's a whole bunch of it that happens long after we're finished, so it's so exciting to be a part of the process and see it come together, and especially with anything and everything in the Marvel universe, it's just on a whole different level.
Congrats on the first two episodes. Can't wait to see the rest. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks, I appreciate it.